Alright, in this video we're going to talk about the periodic table. You have one in your textbook. You can find them all over the place. You can find hundreds of images, maybe even thousands of images of periodic tables on the web, and as you look through them you'll notice that they all look very similar. Occasionally you'll find one that looks a little different, but there is a common way to use and to write the periodic table. What we're going to talk about today is sort of the arrangement of it, some vocabulary that goes along with it, some classifications that go along with it. The periodic table is typically arranged in columns and rows. The rows are called periods. As you go across the table, these are the periods. This is the first period, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh, for example. Sometimes these are numbered, sometimes they're not. As I go up and down, I have groups. These are also called families. The groups, or the families, are in columns such that the elements that are listed in this group have similar chemical characteristics, similar chemical and physical characteristics. Sometimes it's a lot more obvious than others, but we have in the columns similar characteristics. So periods and groups or families. As we look, the groups or families are often numbered slightly different. We see two ways of numbering on this periodic table I have here. One is just simply to number the columns 1 through 18. We also see columns numbered with Roman numerals. This is, for example, 1A, 2A. As we jump down here, we see Roman numerals with the letter B, and then we come back to Roman numerals with the letter A. The A columns of the periodic table are often referred to as the main group elements. The B columns are often referred to as the transition elements or the transition metals. Down here at the bottom, we have two rows which are set off to the side. These two rows are often referred to as inner transition elements. And actually, if we look very closely, they go in the periodic table right here. So they're sort of inserted here. We can look at a picture of a periodic table where those two rows are actually inserted. And so they just make the periodic table much, much wider. All right. Since this width is a little awkward on a normal sheet of paper, we usually take these two rows, these two periods, and we pull them out and squeeze everybody else together. All right. All right. Certain groups or families have specific names associated with them. For example, group 1A, these are known as the alkaline metals. Group 2A are called the alkaline earth metals. Group 7A, these are called the halogens, and group 8A, these are called the noble gases. And you can look up all of these names. You should be familiar with them. Another key feature is this bold line that we have drawn on ours. Not all periodic tables will draw this bold stair-step line, but this is the dividing line between the metals and the nonmetals. We have the metals on the left, we have the nonmetals on the right. One big exception to that is that hydrogen is often written over here on the left, but hydrogen is a non-metal. Sometimes hydrogen is written over here beside helium, but not often. So hydrogen is also a non-metal. Metals are on the left, non-metals are on the right.